गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे आई डिलीवर अगेन लेक्चर ऑन कॉम्प्लेक्स आर्गुमेंट विच इज ए पार्ट ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री, लेक्चर नंबर 5. और फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी डिस्कस अबाउट एक्सपोनेंशियल सीरीज. एंड वी नो दैट e to the power x is equal to 1 plus x square upon factorial 2 plus x cube upon factorial 3 plus x to the power 4 upon factorial 4 plus x to the power 5 by factorial 5 plus so on to infinity. Now in place of I, if we write IX, then we get e to the power IX is equal to 1 plus I square X square upon factorial 2 plus X cube in I cube X cube upon factorial 3 plus I to the power 4 X to the power 4 by factorial 4 I to the power 5, x to the power 5, by factorial 5, plus so on to infinity. Right? Now here, in the right side, there is I power of I. So, write in real part and imaginary part. Because I square give real part. All even power of I are real, whereas odd power of I are imaginary. So we separate right part in the form of a plus ib. So we can write 1 because I square is minus 1. So write x square upon factorial 2, then plus I to the power 4 is 1. So write x to the power 4 upon factorial 4 minus so on. And I x and I cube is minus I, so write minus of x cube divided by factorial 3 and x5, that means plus x to the power 5 by factorial 5 minus so on. And whenever x is real, then we know that this portion, this is cos x and this is your sin x. And therefore e to the power ix, it gives cos x plus I sin x. This is known as Euler's formula. Now e to the power minus I x is equal to, obviously it gives cos x minus I sin x. Therefore adding and subtracting these two quantity, we get cos x. Obviously cos x is equal to e to the power ix plus e to the power minus ix divided by 2, whereas sin x is equal to e to the power ix minus e to the power minus ix divided by 2i. Right? That means you have to remember this 1, 2, 3 and 4 quantity. Now, let us suppose that x is equal to 2n pi I. Therefore, e to the power 2n pi I is equal to cos of 2n pi plus I sin 2n pi. This is equal to 1 and this is equal to 0. So it is 1 plus I into 0, that is 1. Now, therefore e to the power x, now it can be written as e to the power x into 1, that is e to the power x, e to the power 2n pi I. That means e to the power x plus 2n pi i is equal to e to the power x. That is, if suppose that this is denoted by fx, that means therefore we can write f of x plus 2n pi I is equal to fx. That means fx is a periodic function, and therefore fx, which is equal to e to the power x, is a periodic function with period 2n pi, where n is an integer, and whenever n is this positive value, that means e to the power, sorry, 2 pi, e to the power with period 2n pi I. When n is equal to 1, that means we can say that the period of e to the power x is 2 pi I. Now, some basic properties of complex variables. Properties of complex variable. Suppose that if f of x plus iy is equal to u plus iv, first number, then f of x minus iy is equal to u minus iv. Very important property. And similarly, for inverse function, if sine inverse, suppose that x plus iy is equal to u plus iv, then sine inverse x minus iy is equal to u minus iv. Similarly for cos, tan and others. And number third, if e to the power x plus iy is equal to u plus iv, then e to the power x minus iy is equal to u minus iv. And similarly, number fourth is, if log of x plus iy is equal to u plus iv, then log of x minus iy is equal to u minus iv. These are some important properties of complex variable. Now, what is the logarithm of complex number? Next is, logarithm of a complex number. Let us suppose that Z and W are complex numbers such that e to the power z is equal to w, then we can write z is equal to log of w to the base e. Now, we know that abhi turat kiye hai, e to the power z plus 2n pi I, it is equal to e to the power z, and this is equal to w. That means we can write e to the power z plus 2n pi is equal to w. Write number 1. Then again, by definition of logarithm, we can write z plus this. It is log of w. And this log is written by capital L O G, log. That means we write this z plus 2n pi I is equal to log w. This log is known as general value of the logarithm, and therefore log w is equal to z, and by 1 we can write this as log w plus 2n pi I. And this is the definition of logarithm of a complex number. Now, what is the logarithm of a complex number alpha plus I beta? That means, now we have to find the value of this log of alpha plus I beta. For this, where alpha and beta are real numbers. For this, let us suppose that alpha is equal to r cos theta and beta is equal to r sin theta, right? And therefore, alpha square plus beta square is equal to r square. That means r must be equal to alpha square plus beta square to the power 1 by 2. Whereas this divided by this, that is tan theta, is equal to beta upon alpha, that is theta is equal to tan inverse beta by alpha. We can also say that arc of arc tan beta by alpha. This is also known as arc tan beta upon alpha. And therefore alpha plus I beta, now it is r of cos theta plus I sin theta, or it is equal to r into e to the power I theta. Okay, therefore log of alpha plus I beta, it is equal to, by definition, small log w, that is log of alpha plus I beta and plus 2n pi I. Now log alpha plus I beta is equal to log r e to the power I theta plus this, right? Log product of the function, so it is log r plus log e to the power I theta, that is log r plus log e to the power I theta plus 2n pi I. But value of r is alpha square plus beta square to the power half, and therefore log alpha plus I beta is equal to log alpha square plus beta square to the power half plus log e to the power I theta, so write I theta plus 2n pi I. ये power log पर नजर कहाँ जाएगा? Multiple में, so it is equal to half of log alpha square plus beta square plus I common 2n pi plus theta, and theta is equal to tan inverse beta by alpha, and this is the value of log of alpha plus I beta. And the very important formula for complex argument or breaking a complex number in the form of a plus ib. Now, in particular, small log. alpha plus I beta. It will equal to, and this result gives for the for from this formula by putting n is equal to 0. So this value become half of log alpha square plus beta square plus 10 inverse beta by alpha. तो एक चीज इसमें प्रॉब्लम बनाते के समय समझ लेना चाहिए, अगर प्रॉब्लम में कैपिटल एल के साथ दिया हुआ है वैल्यू निकालने के लिए तो जनरल फार्मूला यूज करेंगे, यानी कि ये, और अगर स्मॉल के साथ है या कुछ नहीं बोल रहा है उसमें तो इसके साथ लेके चलेंगे, या प्रूफ करने में जब रिजल्ट देखेंगे एन के साथ है तो कैपिटल एल ये फार्मूला लगा लेना है, अदरवाइज ये फार्मूला लगेगा, ये चीज को ध्यान में रखना है, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है इतना. देन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस वी कैन फाइंड, सपोज दैट इनवर्स के लिए फॉर एग्जांपल व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ साइन इनवर्स आई फॉर दिस, सपोज दैट दिस इज इक्वल टू थीटा, दैट मींस साइन थीटा इज इक्वल टू आई, राइट. Now, e to the power I theta by Euler's formula, we know that cos theta plus I sin theta. Now, cos theta is equal to under root 1 minus sin square theta or plus I sin theta. So, putting the value of sin theta, that is I square, and I square is minus 1, so it gives 1 plus 1, that is root 2. And I square minus 1. That means e to the power I theta is equal to this. E to the power I theta is equal to the value of this. That is, e to the power I theta is equal to root 2 minus 1. Ye value hai. ठीक है? Now I theta is equal to, obviously, log milega. And therefore, I theta is equal to log of root 2 minus 1, right? And capital log of this is equal to, that is log root 2 minus 1 plus 2n pi I. And therefore, theta is equal to, I se divide kar denge. So you get 2n pi plus 1 by I, that is minus log root 2 minus 1 minus I 1 by I minus I, and theta is equal to sine inverse x, yeah, theta is equal to sine inverse I, so it is sine inverse I equivalent to this is equal to this. इस तरह से रिजल्ट मिल जाएगा. नाउ कैन यू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ, फॉर एग्जांपल सेकंड एग्जांपल फाइंड, या ऐसे लिख दें इसको, प्रूव दैट द प्रिंसिपल वैल्यू ऑफ alpha plus I beta to the power x plus I y is wholly imaginary. According as, इसमें condition आ जाएगा 1 by 2 times of y log of alpha square plus beta square and plus x 10 inverse beta y alpha e and even or और मल्टीपल ऑफ पाई बाई टू। बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉब्लम, बहुत अच्छा सवाल है। क्या बोला है? द प्रिंसिपल वैल्यू ऑफ दिस, ऑब्वियसली दिस इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ a to the power x, and you know that a to the power x is equal to e to the power x log a, ठीक है? इस फार्मूला को अप्लाई करेंगे तब ये सवाल पर आगे बढ़ेंगे। फिर क्या बोलना है, सवाल के अनुसार बढ़ना है, और सवाल को सॉल्व करना बिल्कुल आसान होता है, केवल सवाल को समझना है, क्या करना है, इसका प्रिंसिपल वैल्यू है और कंडीशन क्या है उसको देखना है, और कंजुकेटिव स्टेटमेंट होगा, राइट स्टेटमेंट जो प्रीवियस को फॉलो करे, बस सवाल का रिजल्ट देगा। दैट मींस हियर गिवन दैट अल्फा प्लस आई बीटा टू द पावर एक्स प्लस आई वाई, सो दिस इज इक्वल टू गिवन दिस, सपोज कर लेट अस सपोज दैट दिस इज इक्वल टू कितना हो गया By this formula, e to the power x plus i y and log of alpha plus i beta. अब break कर देंगे यहाँ log of alpha plus i beta को. This implies that alpha plus i beta to the power x plus i y is equal to e to the power x plus i y. And this is equal to half log alpha square plus beta square or plus I tan inverse beta by alpha. Okay. Then what will happen? इसको break करेंगे और भी, इसका real part और imaginary part कितना आ जाएगा? Now it is equal to e to the power real part. Real part में कितना आ जाएगा? Real into real. That means half of x log alpha square plus beta square और imaginary into imaginary I square minus y tan inverse बीटा वाई अल्फा, ठीक है? प्लस इमेजिनरी पार्ट आई इंटू हाफ वाई, दैट मींस हाफ ऑफ वाई लॉग अल्फा स्क्वायर प्लस बीटा स्क्वायर, और दिस इमेजिनरी इंटू रियल दैट इज प्लस एक्स tan inverse beta y alpha. तो अब इसको भी ब्रेक कर सकते हैं e to the power a plus ib, ये फॉर्म है, that means it is equal to e to the power we can write u plus ib, where u mean this is equal to u, this portion is equal to u and this becomes d. Now break this, that is e to the power u into e to the power iv, and e to the power iv by Euler's formula it gives cos b plus I sin b. अब प्रॉब्लम के पार्ट में चलेंगे, प्रॉब्लम में क्या बोल रहा है? The given quantity is wholly imaginary. Wholly imaginary कब होगा? जबकि रियल पार्ट इसका जीरो होगा. नाउ दिस पोर्शन अल्फा प्लस आई बीटा टू द पावर एक्स प्लस आई वाई इज ओनली इमेजिनरी इफ इट्स रियल पार्ट विल बी जीरो, इफ real part will be zero, and obviously the real part is e to the power e u into cos b. That means e to the power u into cos b is 0, but exponential of this is always positive, so cos b will be 0, and cos b will be 0, it means b is equal to 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. 2n plus 1 into pi by 2. B is equal to kitna? Yeah. That means this will be equal to, that is half of y log alpha square plus beta square plus 10 inverse beta by alpha is क्या हो गया है? ओनली इमेजिनरी के लिए देखना है, इज ओनली इमेजिनरी इफ दिस इज ऑड मल्टीपल ऑफ पाई बाय 2। हाँ, और यही चीज यदि इवन मल्टीपल यहां पर कर ले होली रियल पार्ट, तो सवाल में भी थोड़ा चेंज कर लेंगे कि अगर ये होली रियल पार्ट हो जाए तब रियल पार्ट के लिए इमेजिनरी पार्ट यहां पर तब जीरो होगा, ये क्या चेंज हो जाएगा, इमेजिनरी पार्ट विल बी जीरो और इमेजिनरी पार्ट में आ जाएगा दिस साइन बी, साइन बी इज इक्वल टू जीरो, ठीक है, साइन बी बराबर जीरो का मतलब हो जाएगा बी इज इक्वल टू एन पाई, और इसको कैसे लिख सकते हैं, दैट इज टू एन इन टू पाई बाई टू, एंड टू एन इज इवन नंबर एंड देयरफॉर इवन मल्टीपल ऑफ पाई बाई टू, राइट। तो सवाल इस तरह से बनेगा, और आगे फिर से सवाल इस पर जो रेस्ट प्रॉब्लम कुछ बचा हुआ है इसको हम लोग नेक्स्ट क्लास में देखेंगे, और आज बस इतना ही, फिर नेक्स्ट क्लास के लिए मिलते हैं। ओके, थैंक यू।